Good morning students and welcome back in our today's session. In our previous session we have discussed the half part of the story and the name of that story is His First Flight. In that session I told you the self realization is a very important thing and do not handicap your children. That quotation also we have discussed in my first video. If you have not watched, then please watch it, because without watching first video you are unable to get what I want to say, what I am talking. And in the same video I told you the story of a seagull, and their family. Apart from that seagull, young seagull, all of the family members were expert or master in flying, but that seagull was not, because he had a phobia, means he had a fear. What fear was that? He had a fear that he could not fly, because his wings would never support him to fly. That was his fear, and he always felt that his wings are very short, but in reality was different, and the reality was that his wings was compared with the other seagulls, means his brothers and sisters, the wings was longer than his brothers and sister. And but due to the fear, he was always expecting by their parents, means his parents would give him something to eat. But on that day the parent had decided no, he must do it, because our parent also sometimes they are scolding on us. Why they are scolding on us? Because they are knowing the reality. If you are not doing this certain thing in that age, suppose you're even today also our parents are telling us, yes, do this thing, do study. Yes, it is a time of study. After certain age your parents may not say that you have to do study. Suppose you got a good job and if you started to work, then that time your parents will never tell you have to do this study. No, but it is a time, it is a proper age of doing study. And so friends, don't waste your time and concentrate on the study, because some things are there, so many things are there. If the time has passed away, then you cannot get return. You cannot get return, and because of that utilize your time. And their parents also was knowing that if he couldn't do it, means if he couldn't take an effort, then he would die by the hunger. And because of that the parents were upbraiding him, means scolding him, and it means scolding on him. They were threatening him and to let him starve on his leg unless he flew away. Means they had decided if he couldn't fly, then they would not give him food to eat. Since 24 hours he hadn't eaten anything, and because of that he was too much hungry. He had a lot of expectation. He was watching all these things, how his parents were giving a training to his siblings, means his sisters and brothers, how they were giving a training to it, a training to them. That all points he was watching very well, but he couldn't dare to fly. And the parents was also stubborn, and they had firmly stick on their decision. They was firm on their decision, and because of that they also hadn't pay attention towards him. And since 2 days, since 24 hours he hadn't eaten anything. Now he was too much hungry. I think until this point I was discussing all these things in my previous point, previous video. If you haven't watched it, then please, I will suggest you please watch it. Then after we will discuss, then and then only you will get whatever I am explaining now. Friends, he stepped slowly out to the brink of the ledge, and standing on the one leg with the other leg hidden under his wings, he closed one eye then other and pretended to be falling asleep. See, he was pretending Actually, he was expecting that his parents will feel mercy on him and they would give him something to eat. And so he was doing acting, means he was pretending. Okay. And see, he had closed one eye and then other. See? And standing on one leg with other leg hidden under his wing. Okay. He was doing acting. Still, they took no notice him. By doing this acting, he was expecting that his parents would pay attention towards him. In our house also, we are doing the same things. When someone beat us, okay, then to catch the attention of our parents, we are started to crying very loudly. Okay. Suppose our brother or sisters had beaten you, and at that time, actually they have not beaten very harshly. Then also we are starting to cry very loudly. Because of that, the parents would pay attention towards him and they would beat him. Okay, that are our expectation. Here the seagull expectation was that his parents would pay attention towards him and they would give him something to eat. That was his expectation, and that's why he was pretending. Okay. Still they took no notice of him. He saw his two brothers and his sister lying on a plateau, dozing with their heads sunk into their necks. His father was preening. Preening. What does it mean? Preening means here cleaning feathers with a brick. Okay? He was observing what his parents are doing, how they are giving a training to his brothers and sisters. All things he was observing. Okay? Only his mother was looking at him. She was standing on a little high hump on the plateau. Okay? Only the mother had paid attention towards him. Her white dress thrust forward. Now and again she tore a piece of fish that lay at her feet and then scratched each side of beak on the rock. Okay? Well, the mother had paid attention towards him. At that time he felt that mother would give something. But the reality is that what she has done, now and again she tore at a piece of a fish that lay in her feet and then scratched each side of her beak on the rock. The sight of food maddened him. How he loved to tear food that way, scraping his beak now and again to wet it. Gah, gah, gah. He cried, begging her to bring him some food. Actually, see here, when he saw his mother at that time, he felt that his mother is bringing something. Okay? For bringing something to eat. But in reality was that the mother had stayed there. Okay? And he was just begging her to bring him some food. And that's why he was making a sound. Ga, ga, ga. See? Ga, kol, oh. She screamed back derisively. Now down the meaning of derisively, scornfully. See? It was she was too much hungry now. He was unable to understand what to do exactly now. But he kept calling plaintively. After a minute or so, he uttered a joyful scream. His mother had picked up a piece of a fish and was flying across to him with heat. He leaned out eagerly, tapping a rock with his feet, trying to get near to her as she flew across. But she was just opposite him. She halted, her wings motionless, the piece of fish in her beak almost within a reach of his beak. See, actually, he was making a sound. He was begging that his mother would bring something. And just, he kept calling plaintively. Means, plaintively means here, pitifully. he was just calling pitifully, and after a minute, so he uttered a joyful sound. He saw his mother and he felt that yes, mother would bring something. His mother had picked up a piece of fish and was flying across to him with it. See, the mother had picked up a fish in his beak and she was flying across to him with it. That mother was flying across to him with it. He leaned out eagerly, tapping rock with his feet, trying to get near to her as she flew across. And that seagull trying to go near to her, but mother was going across. But when she saw, was just opposite him, she halted her wings motionless. And the mother had gone opposite direction and she halted her wings motionless, the piece of fish in her beak almost within her reach to his beak. He waited a moment in surprise, wondering why she didn't come home. See, the parents had firmly decided, no, he must fly, because they were knowing that if he couldn't fly, then definitely he would die. Okay, they were knowing this reality, and he felt that his mother, at least his mother would bring something. And the mother had brought that piece of a fish. Okay, that piece of fish was there in his beak, and it was flying across, but it couldn't come near. Okay, and that's why he had a surprise. With a loud scream, he fell outward and downward into space. Then monstrous terror. Monstrous terror means here a very great fright. Seized him, his heart stood still. He couldn't hear nothing. But it only lasted a minute. The next moment he felt his wings spread outwards. The wind rushed against his breast feathers, then under his stomach, against his wings. He could feel the teeth of his wings cutting through the air. He was not falling headlong now. He was soaring gradually downwards and outwards. He was no longer afraid. He just felt a bit dizzy. Then he flapped his wings once, soared upwards. See, what happened? When he understood that his parents were not supporting him, and if he couldn't get something to eat, then definitely he would die. That was his condition. See, in our life also same situation is there. Whenever we are getting all things very easily, at that time we never try, we never take any efforts. We never try to take efforts. But when our giver, means our parents, started to stop it, means if they are not giving you, then, and forcefully if you decided, then eagerly, then we may do it. Same thing had happened here. What happened? See, then now monstrous terror, he decided, yes, now I have to do, and he had taken a, see what happened? Then a monstrous terror seized him, his heart stood still, he could hear nothing. Now, he was a very, he was unable to listen anything. But it only lasted a minute. The next moment he felt his wings spread outwards. He felt that his wings are spreading. Means he was taking a step to fly. Now he was taking a step to fly. And see, the wind rushed against his breech feather, then under his stomach, then against his wings. He could fly. So he could flee, the tips of his wings cutting through the air. He was not falling headlong now. He was soaring gradually downwards and outwards. See, he has started to fly now. Okay, when he understood that none are supporting him, that time he mustered up his courage, and then after he started to fly. Ga, 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 ga. Ga could, his mother surpassed him. Her wings making a loud noise, he answered her with another swing. Then his father flew over him screaming. He saw his two brothers and sister flying around him, curvating. Curvating means here, moving gracefully. Now see, when his parents saw that seagulls started to fly over the sky. At that time they become graceful. They had become a graceful. Okay? And banking, soaring and divine. All his brothers, sisters, parents all started become very much happy. They had become very much grateful. Then he completely forgot that he had not always been able to fly. And when they started to appreciate him, at that time he had completely forgotten. What he had forgotten? He forgot that he had not always been able to fly. And commanded himself to dive and saw a curve sinking slowly. He was near the sea now, flying straight over it, facing straight out over the ocean. He saw vast green sea beneath him, the little light moving over it, and he turned his wing sideways and gave a musical sea. When he realized that his parents are not supporting him, they were not giving him anything to eat. The condition was that if he couldn't try to fly, then they would not give him anything to him. That was the condition. And when he observed that the mother is having there, she is near to him, then also she was not coming towards him. Okay? She was just soaring across to him. And when that seagull had observed, at that time he understood that without doing himself, without taking efforts, he would not get anything. And so he mustered up the courage and started to fly. And now when he started to fly, that parents pointed out this thing, and they had become a graceful, and they were started to appreciate to us. And now he had also completely forgotten. What he had completely forgotten? He had forgotten that he had been not able to fly. Okay, that thing he had forgotten. He forgot these things. His parents and his brothers and sisters had landed on the green flooring ahead of him. They were beckoning him, calling Shelly. He dropped his legs to stand on a green sea. His legs sank into it. He screamed with a fright and attempted to rise, again flapping his wing, but he was tired and weak with hunger, and he couldn't rise. Exhausted by strange exercise, his feet sank into green sea, then his belly touched it, and he sank no further. He was floating onto it. Around him, his family was screaming, praising him, and their beaks were offering him his crab, dogfish. See, species of shark. See, and now he had taken a step to fly across the sky. He started to fly, and when this thing pointed out by their parents, at that time they also started to appreciate. They also started to praise him. Okay, they were graceful now. And now he had taken a step and he had forgotten he had not been able to fly. That thing he had forgotten, and now his parents also were appreciating him. But due to the flying, and already you know that he had not eaten anything since 24 hours, since a day, and because of that he was exhausted now. In that situation also the parents were appreciating him, and they were praising him, and now it had caught a fish. Means here the story is over here, and that was his first flight. And so the title is here, his first flight, the seagull first flight. He had taken a first step towards the success, and that's why the title is given, his first flight. I hope that you understood this, friends. Here I would like to tell you one important thing. Same thing, when you realize this ourselves, our strength, yes, we have, like that seagull, we have also the potential to do something heroic. Okay, but problem is that whenever we are getting all these things very easily, at that time we doesn't know what is their gravity. Okay, what is their value? We doesn't know it, and because of that, if it is getting, then yes, we don't have to take. We are not ready to take any effort. But if it has stopped, then we mustered up our courage and we gathered our courage and we started to earn. And because of that, that's why I was given a quotation: don't make handicap to your children by giving everything very easily. That was the quotation. I hope that you understood this lesson very well. You know what does the writer want. Now you understood that what does the writer want to convey throughout this, all this point, all this section. You understood it, and as like that seagulls, you also have to take a first flight towards your success. And your first flight means you have to do something heroic in your student life, and because of that, your parents, your relatives, all should be very happy on you. Okay, they should get the proud on you, and they should become a graceful towards you. And that is, I like it. And because of that, I am suggesting you take your first place. Okay, though it may be wrong, though it may be correct, but try to do your things by yourself. That is very important. Thank you very much, friends. Here we have completed the lesson. Thank you.